Good morning dear students, my name is Ravi Kumar. Today we are going to discuss our very important topic. The topic is of force and the laws of motion. This part is related to the physics. Okay, beta. So we are going to discuss about the term force and then we will discuss about the term laws of motion. First we discuss about the term force. So for considering the term force or for understanding the term force, let us we consider some examples. I am considering here two examples, and by considering that example we will try to understand the meaning of a force and we will try to define the term force. Okay, suppose here I am taking one table here and I have kept the body on this table, and here one ground is here, ground, and here is one football, one ball is rest. Okay, now suppose in this example when we observe the body is at a rest position. Okay, and here the body is in a what? Suppose this body is moving actually in this direction. Okay, the body is in motion condition. So condition is what? In a motion. So there are two conditions here. One is the body is at a rest, and the second is what? The body is in a motion. Now suppose I want to move, or I want to move this body from rest to the motion, then what I have to do? I have to apply some external agency. What I have to do here? I have to apply some external agency. Okay, because of that external agency applied on this body, the body changes its position from rest to the motion. To the motion. Okay, and the position, suppose this is a B and this is a A position. Okay, now, and if, and in this example, if we want to stop the motion of this body, we have to again apply some external agency. And suppose the boy is standing here, the boy is standing here, and the ball when comes near to the boy, then boy stops this ball by pressing the foot on the ball. What happens here? The body is in motion, comes in a rest. And what happens here? The body is in motion, rest, comes in a motion. Because of what? External agency. And that external agency is nothing but the force. Is it clear? So by considering these two examples, we can define the term force as force is a physical quantity when which apply on a body of a rest or body in a motion changes its position from rest to motion or motion to rest. That is simply called as a force. Now this is the definition of a force. What about the unit of the force? Simply, the term force is given by the scientist Newton by his equation F is equal to m into a, and this equation is derived by the scientist Newton. Therefore we use unit as Newton for expressing the force. Got it the meaning of the term force and the unit of the force? Okay, let us now discuss about some characteristics of the force. Okay, some characteristics of the force. There are four characteristics of the force. Now first I will write on the board. We will discuss first and then you can note out in your notebook. First is what? Magnitude. First characteristic is what? Magnitude. First. Second is what, beta? Direction. Third is what, beta? The point of application. Point of application. And fourth is what, beta? Magnitude, direction, point of application, and the nature. Very important property. These are the four characteristics. On basis of these, force can be identified very clearly. Now let us one by one. What is mean by the magnitude? Magnitude is nothing but the value of the force. Means what amount of force you are applying on the body when the body is in rest or whether the body is in motion. What quantity or what value of the force That value is called as the what? Magnitude. Direction is what? Direction is nothing but what, beta? Suppose again I am taking same example here, and if I have kept this body at a rest position, if I want to move this body from left to right, then what I have to define? I have to choose the direction when I want to move this body from left to right. Then apply force from the left direction. Then body comes, or then body will move in a right direction. It means that direction is a very important concept, and which is nothing but the characteristics of the force. This is the second one. And if you want to define clearly the direction, then what you have to define? Just simply the line of action of a force, whether you are applying from left or right. That is nothing but simply the direction. What is about the point of application? Here let us say an example. If you are applying the force at a particular point, that point is called as a point of application. Called as what, beta? Point of application. The point at which we apply the force. What is about the nature? Simply, there are two types of nature. One is a pull nature and another is a push nature. Pull is also called as a tensile, and push is also called as a compressive. Okay, what is mean by the pull and what is mean by the push? Let us consider here again one body, and here is the point of application. If I apply the force away from this point of application, then we call it as a pull force. What we call pull force? And then the second one is what? Suppose same body is I am taking here, and suppose this is a point of application. And if I am applying the force towards the point of application, then it is called as a push force. So these are the very important characteristics of the force. On the basis of this, you can clearly define the force. So what we have learned in this lecture, beta? We have learned that what is mean by the force, what is the unit of a force, and what are the different characteristics of the force. I will again revise in a very short form. Force is a physical quantity which changes the state of a rest or state of a uniform motion of a body, is known as a force. Force concept is given by the scientist Newton. Therefore, SI unit of the force is a Newton, which is given by the equation F is equal to M into A. Then there are four characteristics of the force. One is a magnitude, then direction, point of application, and then fourth is a nature. Okay, what is mean by the magnitude? Magnitude is nothing but the value of the force. Suppose if you are applying the 10 newton, what? 10 newton quantity or magnitude, then this 10 is called as a value or magnitude of that force. What about the direction? Direction is nothing but simply the line of action of a force. What about the point of application? The point at which we apply the force. And what about the nature? There are two types of nature. One is a pull and again is a push. Pull is called as a tensile and push is called as a compressive. Okay, so what is mean by the pull? When the force applied away from the point of application, showing this arrow like this, is called as a pull force. And when the force applied towards the point, means arrow shows towards the point, then it is called as a push force. These are the simple concepts related to the force. Next lecture, we will discuss about the laws of motion. Thank you very much, beta.